Let's give another big hand to Milton Center of the Arts for great hospitality. Ready for some more music? We're gonna play some contemporary stuff, something in the last, say, 20, 30 years? 30? Yes, it was contemporary.
Thank you.
featured there, Miss Coco Lorraine and Tina Jarvis. Come on, give them a great big hand. Beautiful voices. Gotta look for them. People are like, my next concert, I wanna hear more of that. Coco Lorraine and Tina Jarvis. Oh, you can laugh. Come on, that's
what's
sort of
going
fun.
On, Tina?
You know, I mean, I'm a little
what's
bit
going
fun.
On?
CD. Thank you. Well,
I'd like to do.
Anybody know Nina Simone?
Yeah.
Yeah. You're waiting for me to play Sinner Man. That's what you're waiting for. No, I'm not playing that one tonight. No, not tonight. Does anybody know a song called To Be Young, Gifted, and Black? Anybody know that song?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know my family knows that song because they know the set list. But yeah, anybody else? Anybody else know To Be Young, Gifted, and Black?
Yeah.
Okay. So Nina Simone, anyone seen her documentary on Netflix? Anyone see that one? Yeah, you saw? Pretty great documentary, huh? Amazing. You know, so she had this incomparable career. She sang the cover I Know You, Porgy, from Porgy and Bess, and she had a number of couple other songs. And she really was on the level of Aretha Franklin. She was considered one of the biggest. In fact, she was greater. She was considered one of the greatest artists in the world. And during the time of that period, the civil rights movement happened in the States. And she felt obligated to sing songs that spoke about the injustice. And her promoters did not want her to do that. And she did, and she, you know, really, we hear so much Nina Simone now, it's very cool, but she sacrificed her career. She, after that period, did not get dates and really moved into almost obscurity. And people forgot even she was there. She lived in Paris and would play obscure little places and no one even knew who she was. Because she made a personal choice to sing songs like the one I'm gonna play right now. So it's a really powerful song. And so then you ask her, why would you play it? And because I want to play songs that speak about truth. You know, we think about the struggles that people of African descent have in the States and other places, but you know, the TDSB has shared figures that even today, 50% of all black children are not graduating high school. 50%. That's a very severe number. That's a tragedy. Because they don't see themselves, just like little girls don't always see themselves. See, women don't see themselves in magazines, but see airbrushed, distorted images of what a woman should be, and it affects how they think. So these children don't see anything in their history except slaves, really. Now, you know, I was saying to these guys, I have a degree from U of T in history, and I don't remember a thing. Can't remember dates, no. It's like, I don't know, birthday, none. I'm 43, I think, because someone told me. And yet, you know, I went through and had great discussions, but you know, I never learned any African Canadian history. I never learned any contributions. It was only as an actor, as a performer researching that I started to learn about even contributions in this country. It's important for us to teach our children, our human children, who they are. And the many complex, beautiful contributions we have all made as Canadians, of all shades, colors, creeds. But 50% of our children in the TDSB are not graduating because they don't see themselves. And so that's what this song is kind of about. Thank you.
And I am haunted by
So, you know, a revelation has happened to me. You're seeing before your eyes. It's that eye is funny. I've come to realize that I need glasses. And I've been finding it. It's like, no, man, I wear orange shirts and blue ties, man. I don't need no glasses.
Welcome
to your world. But you guys look cool over there with glasses, so I'm gonna do all right.
Very cool.
Yeah. Okay. So I was gonna play four songs, but I'm gonna play three songs. The next song I'm gonna play is
Want my glasses?
You're funny. You're funny, okay. Right. I was gonna sing, should I play a fast song or a slow song? What do you think?
Fast song?
Fast one?
Yeah.
No, but I was thinking of slow. See, that's why it's good to ask. All right. This song's gonna feature Mr. Vito Reza, and you're gonna be in for a treat.
Ain't no need for sunlight.
Ain't no need
Thank you.
I thought that was like the cue. It's time to go. You guys need to finish up.
You know, like when you're in the restaurant
too long, you're like, oh, having such a good time in the light. Oh, wait, what? Did you see the lights? Okay, we got one more. Is that good? Because we featured Coke Lorraine and Tina Jarvis. Come on, give them a great big hand. Beautiful singers. We featured Mr. Andrew Stewart. Come on now. That last song, we featured Mr. Vito Reza. I mean. So we really featured everybody. We can go home. Thank you very much. Good night. No, we can't go home yet. Even if you turn on the lights, we gotta sing one more, I'm just saying. And this song is a famous, famous song, so it's probably good. So famous that I'm looking up the words. Ain't that a shame? That's just a shame. I would like to introduce you to Mr. Nick Tateshi on guitar.
I know.
To the Canadian Caribbean Association of Halton Region. I want to give a great big thanks. Please, all the board members, why don't you stand on up and get a good applause. We can say thank you very much for putting on this show. Big thanks to Chris and Mark on sound and lighting. Milton Center of the Arts, and a big thanks to yourselves for enjoying the show and the great warmth you've shown us. We thank you very much. Have a great evening.